Good morning, students. We are here again in the class of physical education. Yesterday we have started the topic yoga. As you know, yoga is nowadays yoga is very prevalent in our society. Everyone, what is not in India only, abroad also, but in many also people are seeing yoga. They are performing yoga daily because it is a good act. What to say? Good exercise to be able to keep oneself fit. Keep oneself fit. So they are we have yesterday we have done what is the meaning of yoga, what is the definition of yoga. After that comes, okay, what is the importance of yoga in one's life? What is the importance of yoga in one's life? So yesterday we have done it helps to prevent us from major diseases. And it is a prevention, it acts as a prevention and cure for major diseases. Now comes maintenance of the correct posture. Maintenance of correct posture, generally nowadays everyone is having a sedentary lifestyle. Sedentary lifestyle means they are not able to utilize their energy properly. They are sitting and doing their work. They are not able to do the exercise properly. Generally, it is said that you should do exercise daily. But it can be in the form of jogging, running, walking, and all that. But nowadays, what people are when they go to office and they come back to work. But after that, they don't go for exercise, walking, etc. So they are living a sedentary lifestyle. Because of the sedentary lifestyle, what is happening? It is giving birth to different diseases. It is giving birth to different diseases as well as deformity in the body. It is giving different deformities in the body. So, if you are having different deformities in the body, by performing various asanas, you can slowly and gradually remove those deformities. For example, performing Bhujangasana, performing Mayurasana, or performing Chakrasana. So these are different asanas. This is an example of it. Performing different asanas help you to cure the different deformities from your body. It might not go away fully, but little bit deformity, it can be improved posture also. And because of the deformity, it has gone down. If you are having a good posture, what happens? You look attractive. It gives a good look to the people looking at you. After that comes enhancement of ethical values. Generally, those who are doing yoga, they are self-contained. They are having time. They don't go for, they are not feeling greedy and all that. What generally people are nowadays. It is said because they, what is the meaning of yoga? It says, be away from asatya, be away from ahimsa, be away from hinsa. So you have to follow some rules and regulations when you are doing yoga. Away from hinsa, after that comes, away from non-violence, away from violence, away from violence, after that comes, away from asatya. So these are some of the limits that you have to follow while doing yoga. After that comes increasing flexibility. Generally, as the age grows, and what happens? Flexibility of one individual body decreases. Flexibility of one body decreases. Now again, by performing various asanas, again here the name will come, again the name of the asana will come, you will say over Bhujangasana. Flexibility of the and you are relaxing your body as well as you are gaining the flexibility for you have what is the body of the back. Ardha Marsyendrasana. After that comes Paschimottanasana. Again, the flexibility of the lower back and flexibility of the back. These are some of the asanas by which you can regain your flexibility and therefore you can gain your flexibility. After that comes spiritual development. What is spiritual development? Spiritual development. The guide to physical health through yoga is linked to the guide to physical health. Linked to the guide to spiritual health. The body is interested in the meaning. What was the meaning of yoga? To unite. Unite the Atma with the Paramatma. Again, here it comes. Reconciling the body with the spirit is the main objective of yoga. This can be achieved by observing asanas like Padmasana, that is lotus pose. So they are different asana by which you can achieve. Now here was maintenance of correct body posture. Sedentary lifestyles of today's society, like working for long hours, and generally nowadays what is the style of working? Sitting only, not standing or running here. On the computer only, or working on the laptop only. So pure over utilization of body energy and excessive use of gadgets. Nowadays, from the if we are seeing from class 1 onwards, class 3 onwards, more children are using mobile. They are much advanced to the older people. They are much advanced. They will be generally using gadgets for the laptop, etc. So they are not happy in doing exercise outside the home, but they are happy in playing. What time? If you tell them to do exercise, they will do exercise in home only. Tell them to play. What they will do? They will play with the gadgets only. They will play. They are very happy playing video games, etc. But not playing outdoor games where they actually will be utilized. So what is happening? They are leading to poor body posture. So and excessive use of gadgets make our body more hunched. Similarly, what happens with hunchback, etc. Because total every time you are keeping on mobile, what is happening? Chances of hunchback is more. Chances of hunchback is more. That can lead to kyphosis also. So such a poor posture deformity can be prevented by performing yoga asana like Mayurasana, that is called pose, Chakrasana, that is deep pose, and Bhujangasana, etc. That is cobra pose and so on. So different asanas are there for the correction of the body posture. After that, of increasing flexibility, the practice of yoga can make the body more flexible. Giving the muscles and joints a greater range of motion. If you are having greater flexibility, what happens? Your range of motion is more compared to when you are having less flexibility. A flexible body is less prone to injuries. Whoever is having a flexible body, generally, they are having good coordination. Generally, if you might have seen the dancers, their body is flexible. They are able to do every movement easily without any body injury and all that. They are able to move easily from here to there. Like Michael Jackson, they were very flexible. Now, similarly, gymnasts, their body is very flexible and they are less prone to injury. So, a flexible body less prone to injury because it can withstand physical stress to a greater degree. Because your range of motion increases when you have a more flexibility. Yogasanas can improve the outer look of the body giving the practitioner a toned muscles, and an attractive body. After that comes reduction of obesity. Generally, whatever people are even while sitting, while having a sitting lifestyle, what happens? You are eating more, but you are not doing exercise. You are gaining more calories, but you are losing less calories. What happens? Chances of being obese is more compared to what you have done exercise. So, because of this reduction of obesity, so there are different asanas by which you can reduce the obesity or you can be away from the obesity. Different limbs of yoga on which the yoga is totally dependent. They are different eight limbs of yoga. Eight limbs of yoga. First one is yam. Second one niyam. After it comes asana. Pranayama. After that comes यम नियम आसन प्राणायाम एंड धारणा ध्यान प्रत्याहार एंड समाधि ऑन विच ऑन दीज एट ग्रुप्स योगा इज वेरी डिपेंडेंट. सो नाउ व्हाट इज यम जनरली दिस यूनिवर्सल मॉरलिटी एंड एथिक्स. एथिक्स दैट मीन्स देयर सब डिसिप्लिन्स ऑफ यम. देयर सब डिसिप्लिन्स ऑफ फाइव सब डिसिप्लिन्स ऑफ यम ऑल्सो. दैट इज अहिंसा. दैट मीन्स अवे फ्रॉम द हिंसा. दैट इज कंपैशन फॉर ऑल लिविंग बीइंग्स. सत्य कमिटमेंट टू ट्रुथ. सत्य मीन्स कमिटमेंट टू ट्रुथ. बी ट्रुथफुल. डोंट टेल लाई. आफ्टर दैट कम्स असत्य. दैट इज अपोजिट ऑफ सत्य. दैट इज अवॉइडेंस ऑफ स्टीलिंग और बीइंग हैप्पी. अवॉइडेंस ऑफ स्टीलिंग और बीइंग हैप्पी व्हाट वन हैज गॉट. ब्रह्मचर्य. दैट इज कॉन्करिंग द बॉडली डिजायर्स. कॉन्करिंग द बॉडली डिजायर्स. यू आर अवे फ्रॉम द लस्ट. You are a homosexual desire, as well as super lust. Now comes apigraha, conquering the greed, control the greed, that is apigraha. So these are, under this, they are high self-discipline. After that comes niyam. Niyam ke andar hota hai personal rules, comprising soch. Soch means cleaning of the body and mind. Cleaning of the body and mind. We'll be discussing it later on. Yeah. Now we are just discussing briefly only, but we will be explaining it afterwards. After that comes santosh. So what is santosh means? You are happy with what you have got. That is contentment. After that comes tap. Tap in Hindi you might have heard the word tap, but in English it means proper use of the body energy. Proper use of the body energy. That is tap. And swadhyay, self-examination. Swadhyay means self-examination. Examining yourself. That again you are engineered by meditation, by concentration. By meditation you are able to concentrate on. So that is swadhyay. After that comes Ishvara Pragya, celebration of the spiritual, to surrender to the God. After that comes asana. You might have heard asana. Baba Ram Bodhi Uttan Asana, Kesaran Asana, others Self Asana, Phalasana. So they are different poses of the body. They are different poses of the body of Hindu Yoga. So what is Asana? That is body postures. But while doing any Asana. Pranayama, what is Pranayama? You might have heard about Pranayama. Breathing exercises and control of Prana. That is internal energy. Control of Prana. That is internal energy. Pratyahara, control of the senses. You should be able to control the senses. That is known as Pratyahara. Dharana means concentration. Concentration. Dhyana. By the word itself, you can understand what dhyana, meditation. Or devotion, meditation to the divine will. That is why, aap kya kehte hain, okay, dhyana lagao. Dhyana lagao means meditate. Go for meditation, dhyana lagao. Like, समाधि. जनरली यू माइट हैव हर्ड दैट हियर इज इट कॉल्ड फॉर समाधि. दैट इज यूनियन विद द डिवाइन. यूनियन विद द डिवाइन दैट इज नोन एज समाधि. सो देयर आर एट इन फॉर्म ऑफ योगा. अंडर दैट कम्स यम नियम आसना. बॉडी आसना बॉडी पोजिशन. प्राणायाम. यू आर एबल टू कंट्रोल योर ब्रीथ. दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम वन साइड one of the muscles you inhale, other then controller, you are holding the breath and then you go for exhalation. After that, inhalation, again inhalation goes to the other side and exhalation goes to the other side. That is pranayama. You might have heard of the pranayama, there is no movement of it. All this comes under pranayama. After that comes dhana. So what is dhana? Concentration. Dhana means concentration and dhana means devotion. Or meditation, or you can say meditation on the divine will. You are meditating on the will of the God. That is called meditation. Then what happens? We have heard that all these visions, they go for dhyana. they go for, they are going for Brahmins, they are meditating with the will of the God, because they are all away, all of them are away from the, like, all the greed, they are away from the world. They don't have any greed, they are self-satisfied people. They are satisfied people. They don't run for money and all that. They are happy with what they have got. So they are, that is why they are going for dhyana. When they go for dhyana after many years, what we say, unhone samadhi lagayi, union of the soul with the divine soul, union of the soul with the divine. And what is pratyahara? You should be able to control the senses. You should be able to control the senses. So these are the eight limbs of yoga. And in them, we will be discussing in our next class. Not just about the eight limbs I have told you. What are the eight limbs of yoga? Okay. After that, also, what are the importance of yoga? I have told you the points. Just go and just go when the question comes, write here, write about every point. Into folding, right? About into folding, okay, it gives you flexibility. What happens? Your chances of injury will be less if you are having more flexibility. Your range of motion will be more compared to that. Without having less flexibility, and you are less able to grow. Similarly, you look attractive by doing yoga means you will not produce any deformity inside of your body. You will not get any deformity in the body. They are different deformities in the spinal deformity, then after that comes bow legs, after that comes long knees, etc. So these are the postural deformities from what general people have. But as they grow older, these deformities go away. And if you are doing that, but still it sustains in one individual by performing different types of asana, we can cure these postural deformities. We can move the postural deformities. As I told you, there are different deformities in the body. Spine, what to say, spine. The spinal deformities, kyphosis, scoliosis, lordosis, etc. After it comes, bow legs. Now, it is whenever you are walking, whenever you are running, etc., your knees will be rubbing to each other. The feet will be rubbing to each other. So, by performing asana, by performing yoga, but under yoga, by performing different asanas, you can keep away the deformities away from the body. You can increase the flexibility. You can, what to say, if you are performing yoga, generally you will be away from the knee, etc. You will not feel, you will be self satisfied. You will be self satisfied. Nahi paise ikatthe karne nahi hai. That is something different. You will be self satisfied. You will be happy with what you have got. Because of the eight limbs of yoga, you are the eight limbs of yoga. And because of this, you will be self-satisfied. So in our next class, we will be dealing about the eight yoga in detail. So what are the eight yoga I have told you? Now in detail, we will discuss in our next class. Till then, take care. Be safe.